Guess what, Central Baptist Church? Sunday, March the 28th, is Palm Sunday. That's exciting because it's Palm Sunday, but also because it marks the beginning of Holy Week. Hands down, the most important period of time on the Christian calendar the world over. And, of course, it's a very important period of time here at Central Baptist Church. I want to talk to you a little bit about what Holy Week will look like this year at Central Baptist. We're so happy to say that we will have all of our Holy Week services back here on our campus with a few little changes. So first of all, on Sunday, March the 28th, Palm Sunday, in terms of the times, that will look like a regular Sunday. Two worship services, 9 and 10:30. Two Sunday schools, 9 and 10:30. Then on Monday and Tuesday, we'll have our midday prayer services. Both of those services on March 29th and March 30th, Monday and Tuesday, will be from 12:10 to 12:50. That period of time right there in the lunch hour. We want to encourage you to try, if there's any way you can, to be here on Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday night, Thursday night, and Friday night, the services will all be at 6 p.m. here in the sanctuary. Wednesday night, everyone will gather together here in the sanctuary. Thursday is Maundy Thursday. Maundy Thursday is when we observe the Lord's Supper. Now, normally in a normal Holy Week, we'll observe that by intinction, everyone coming forward one pew at a time and observing the Lord's Supper up front. But this year, we're going to once again have you grab a Lord's Supper packet at one of the side tables, take it with you to your pew, and we'll be observing the Lord's Supper on Maundy Thursday in that way. Good Friday, that is our Tenebrae service. That's the service that ends with the extinguishing of the seven candles that are symbols of the seven last words of Christ on the cross. That'll be 6 o'clock here in the sanctuary that Friday night. Immediately following the Good Friday service, we're going to open up the lower parking lot and do what we did last year. We're going to invite you to come, bring your family, pile everyone in the vehicles, and come drive around the seven last words of Christ display, which will have you driving around the cross in the middle of the lower parking lot. And once again, like so many of you did last year, we want to invite you, if you feel so led, to bring flowers and roll down your windows and throw your flowers there at the foot of the cross. I know that's kind of different, but it's just kind of a way that we embraced last year, and again, so many of you embraced this, to say how much the Lord Jesus means to you. So plan on coming to that. We'll have no services on Saturday, and then on Sunday, April the 4th, we have Easter Sunday. Now, a few little changes with Easter Sunday. This is what it's going to look like this year. This year, we'll have the sunrise service outside up front at 8:15 a.m. Immediately following the sunrise service, which will end somewhere around 8:30, you're going to have 30 to 40 minutes to fellowship together. Now, we're not going to do a full breakfast hot buffet like we normally do. But what we're going to do is invite you to go to one of the three food stations we're going to have set up. One outside where we had the service, another in the fellowship hall, and another in the rec. And at those food stations, you'll be able to pick up a pre-packaged continental breakfast item, a muffin or a pastry or something like that, a bottle of water or a bottle of juice, and you'll be able to stand around for a bit and visit while trying your best to practice social distancing. Sunday school will happen at 9 o'clock. We're gonna ask that everyone be out of the fellowship hall and the rec, certainly no later than 9:10, because Sunday school will begin at that time, 9 to 9:10, somewhere in there. We'll have the two worship services Easter as well, 9 a.m. here in the sanctuary and 10:30 here in the sanctuary, and our two Sunday schools, 9 o'clock as I already mentioned, and 10:30 as well. Now, we are aware of the fact that the governor is supposed to be making some announcements sometime in the very near future. But for our purposes, we're going to go ahead and say that masks will be required on Easter Sunday morning, regardless of what the governor says, and that's for this reason. We expect to have a lot of people here, and we're just going to ask you to honor this. We will assess whatever the governor says after Easter and make any adjustments that need to be made to our policies. But Easter Sunday morning, masks will be required regardless of what the governor says. We are going to remove the tape from every other row of pews or seats all over the sanctuary with the exception of under the balcony. So you can still social distance under the balcony. The tape will be removed in the front part of the floor level and in the balcony as well. Furthermore, in the 10:30 hour on Easter Sunday morning, we're going to have an overflow area in the fellowship hall where the service will be live streamed and projected there on a screen. Meaning, if you want to come but you're uncomfortable being in the sanctuary, you can go in the fellowship hall and sit there and keep distance from folks and participate, sing along, and then watch the service there in the fellowship hall. Thank you for cooperating and helping us with all of the kind of ways we have to make adjustments for this year's Holy Week, but we are beyond thrilled to say we're going to be back this Holy Week. We hope to see you at every one of the services, if at all possible. God bless you guys.